This is a quick introduction of how to use the Philosopher's Index. We will begin at the university's webpage, click Academics, and scroll down to Library. This takes you to the Phillips Library's landing page. Click Databases A to Z. This launches a new tab. Click P. Scroll down, you'll see that we have access to four different philosophy databases: Past Masters Philosophy, Philosopher's Index, Philosophy Documentation Center, and Phil Papers. We'll use today Philosopher's Index. You can enter any search term in the search bar and apply other limitations or filters. Let's look for final causes. Here we see the results. Some of these results are linked full text. Some are PDF full text, which means that we can pull up the actual document right now today. Others indicate that we need to request the item through Interlibrary Loan. Suppose I want to read this article, Nested Explanation in Aristotle and Mayer. I click it. I get a screen with information about this, the name of the journal, the edition, the page numbers. This is from 2016, so it's quite recent, and an abstract. After I read the abstract, if I decide that I would like to request the article, I would click over here on the left side to request the article through Interlibrary Loan. This would bring up an Interlibrary Loan request form where I would put in my name and library barcode number and click Submit. In this case, I'm going to go back and take a look at this article, Without Purpose, Modernity, and the Loss of Final Causes. Again, I get a page with information in the abstract. This is from May of 2010, a journal article about the nature of boredom. If I decide I'd like to read it, it's linked here as PDF full text. I simply click that link, and the article downloads, and in my case, with my browser settings, opens in my own version, my resident version of Adobe Acrobat. It may also open in your browser window. I can save it to my hard drive if I wish. I will go back again and take a look at this other type of article, linked full text, this article in Aristotle and Spinoza, Journal of the History of Philosophy, July 2016. Again, an abstract that I can read to discover if I want to read the full article. I click linked full text and it launches a new tab, taking me to EBSCOhost to see if I can get access to the full text of the journal. And here we are in the link. I can now scroll through and read online the entire text of the article. If I wish to download it, I can click up here. And again, as before, I will either in my browser or in my resident Adobe Acrobat end up with a copy of the article, which I can then print or save to my hard drive as I like. Going back now to our search screen, if I want to enter advanced search, I can limit my searches to peer review, to things that are just book reviews or journal articles. I can limit them by publication or availability of full text. I can repeat my search with those filters. I discover my 300 results is now down to 55, but in each case here, I have just either PDF full text or linked full text available. I could also limit these by subject keyword, by date, using these sliders here. If I want to read only articles published in the last 10 years, I can drag my sliders in that way. My number of results is now down to 33. If I wish, I can take off some of my limiters. If I do not wish to limit myself just to peer-reviewed journal articles, it turns out that doesn't make any difference in this case. So, that is a quick introduction to the way to use the Philosopher's Index to get access to recent philosophy scholarship. I hope you found it helpful. Goodbye.